Hello, good day to everyone, and I welcome you to another episode on Moldflow's tips and workflow. If you have been following to my episodes on what's new in Autodesk Moldflow 2025, in one of the episodes I mentioned about the tips to improve the analysis speed in Moldflow 2025. In today's episode, I'm going to demonstrate or show you the tips how you can improve the analysis speed. We are going to make some changes to the compute manager configurator file as well as onto the task manager and processes where your 3D flow exe file is been running. A word of caution before we go and make these changes to the default setting, because in default setting we have made the arrangement that you run a parallel applications to the Moldflow. But if we make these changes, as I demonstrate to you, you may feel a little lag of response to those applications which are running in parallel to it. So before you go ahead and make those changes, I would recommend that not running in heavy applications in parallel to the Moldflow, because that may have slow response to that applications, or probably you may reduce down the speed of that applications. So with that, probably let's get started and I'll show you what changes we can make to our configurator file. And I also try to run a few of the analysis in the background and show how this response would look like after making those changes. So first and foremost thing that I would like to go into the file explorer, and I'm going to go in the file explorer, go into the your Windows C. In Windows C, in program data, and look for the Autodesk folder, and you should look for an simulation compute folder, and in that V2 and config, and look for the compute provisioner dot config dot json. I'm going to open this file into the notepad editor, or I have like an edit with notepad plus plus, but you can always open with the default applications that comes with the window, like an edit in the notepad. Make sure that you have an admin right to make these changes. If you don't have an admin rights, probably these changes may not be effective. Okay, so with that, probably I'll go and open it into the notepad plus plus, and we should look for the in control F. Let's go and look for that, and I'm going to look for the priority actually. Okay, this is what I'm going to look at. Just click into this, copy it, and here go find. Okay, so if you can see that I can find all, find next. So I'll start with the Synergy 2025, and by here's the name of that, the what we are making the changes, that's a label. And we are going to look for the priority once the job is been, or the probably the response of that applications, how you want to put it against the rest of the things. So priority is pretty much the normal. I'm going to change these to 2. Okay, you have an optional. If you don't want to make that your synergy response to be faster, or probably if you're working on a normal model, not on the heavy model, then probably you can just keep it as 1 as a default. But when you go onto the Insight 2025, that's the solver where I'm going to change the application or priority to 2. What does it mean that I'm going to now, when I run the analysis, is going to be above the normal? And pretty much that's it. We are going to make only 2 changes, and we are going to run the analysis and see if what is, and then you may have to make it a save. And as you need an admin rights to make these changes, I have made the changes to it, and you can also see that I can make the analysis speed limit to 3 as well. Even if you make it 4, it's not going to go. The maximum is 3. So probably if you want to run only one analysis at a time, you can make these changes over here as well. Okay, we are going to go back now. Yes, probably. And okay, we are going to go back and I'm going to run this analysis now. Let's see. And I'm going to launch it. At the same time, so what I'm going to do is I'm also going to launch these two more analysis as well, so that I can show you, even if you don't make the changes to these configurator file, you can still make the changes to the into the task manager as well. So that probably I would, the analysis is started, begin. I will look for the task manager. Again, you'll need admin rights to make all these changes. So in the task manager, if you go over here, make sure that you on the command line into the processes. So I'm into the processes and make sure that you on the command line. If it is not there, probably you have to go over here and on the command line. So why? Because we want to find the name of that particular study file for which we want to change the priority. Okay, now we need to go and look for the exe file that's running. So you need to look for the simulation compute manager. Scroll it down pretty much. Sorry for this, it should be here. Simulation compute manager. Okay, yeah, simulation compute files 35. And if I click on this, I should be able to see all of these three files. You can see that it is IET1, IET2, and IET3. And if I go and look for the details, okay, I'm not sorry. Not for that. Oops, sorry. Task manager, yes, and okay. Pretty much, I see. I can see that the response has reduced, and so make sure that you know. Where is it? So give a time to look at that file. Go down, go down, go down, go down. Here it goes, 32, and then go into the details, and you can see into the get some time, wait for it to the details to come up. So because the analysis are running in parallel, and then probably you can see set the priority. You can see it is above the normal, then you can change it to the normal if you want it. And you can do it for the multiple analysis as well. So if you are running all of these two analysis, you can see the priority of this one is above normal, but you can change it. Say that I want to put this as normal. Yes, change the priority, and then this also I want to change the priority as normal. Yes. And so that only one analysis, that is one that will run at the higher priority compared to the rest of the two. So you can define, sometimes you know, question has been asked, can I change the priority of these analysis? Yes, but this is not the one step process we are running here, is the flow analysis. So if you are changing it to the cool analysis or warp analysis, again you have to come here and you have to change the priority settings. But if you make the changes into the compute manager file, all of the analysis that you're going to run will run with a higher priority or with a normal priority. You can put it to the 3 as well. That will take you through the almost like, you know, setting above very high priority. Okay, so all of the analysis that will be run, then it will be on the high priority. So as a word of caution, as I mentioned, that make sure that you are not hampering the rest of the application. As you can see that I'm struggling a little bit to open the applications because a lot of the resources are gone into the computation purpose. So pretty much that's what I want to show it. I hope this session was useful to you, and you can now look for improving your analysis speed depending upon your priority and how you want to make best of your time or take the best of your hardware as well. With that, probably I will catch you on to the next episode. Take care. Talk to you again. Bye.